get ready to match the stars. Buddy Ron! Noli Brown! Johnny Bass! Joy Chambers! Philippe Brady! And Peter Tabano! As we play Graham Kennedy's Blankety Blanks! And now, as the doors magically open, behold in all his sartorial glory the star of this extravaganza, Graham Kennedy!
Good evening and welcome to Blankety Blanks. We are 52 episodes old tonight.
Many happy returns.
How about that? That means if we were played once a week, we'd be a year old. Yes. But we're not. We're on five nights a week. Hello, top row.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Graham.
Graham.
Hello, bottom row.
Good evening, Mr.
Graham. I hope I'm not struck down. Did you want me to say something?
No, Phil, go for it.
I just hope I'm not struck down because I have worn a tie tonight which covers up my St. Christopher medal. I hope
is
it's not unlucky.
I think St. Christopher's long since gone. He was wiped off the Catholic calendar. Mm.
Well, I've always been a bit old-fashioned.
Anyway, St. Christopher has gone because I was in Rome once and I saw him get run over outside the Vatican. I'd like you to meet Catherine Twyford, our champion, and our new challenger tonight is Lawrence Sutton. Hello, Lawrence. How much have you got? $100. Catherine's got $100. Lawrence joins the show tonight, so he hasn't got any money. Tell us the Lawrence Sutton story.
I'm 27 years old. I'm married with a son named Michael, 3.5 years old.
Yes.
And I'm a manager for Kentucky Fried Chicken.
You're a Kentucky Fried Chicken gentleman. Which outlet is yours? Which one?
King's Cross.
The King's Cross one. Hey, that's some turnover there. That must be the good one to get in New South Wales, I'd think. Yes. Kentucky Fried Chicken. A or B, Lawrence?
A, thank you.
A. This is the first match of tonight's episode, so everybody plays and every match is worth a point. I can't get over the fact that we're 52.
Guess how many episodes of Casino 10 I've done so far?
I don't know, Philip. How many episodes of Casino 10 have you done so far?
437, ladies.
Guess how many episodes.
Thank you.
Guess how many episodes of Celebrity Game we've done.
How many Celebrity Games have you done?
284.
All right. Peter Tapano. What's that, darling?
I don't know how many of the Young Doctors we did.
How many Young Doctors?
I don't know.
Neither do I. Good answer. Guess how many In Melbourne Tonight's and Graham Kennedy shows I did.
Yes, how many did you do?
4,922. And I've got a dollar for every one. I beg your pardon. Johnny?
Guess how many times I've played Malabar RSO?
How many times?
Once and never again.
Why, it's a rough one?
Well, it's all prison officers. That'll give you a clue.
If
they do a joke they don't like, they come up and bash you.
Yes, I suppose. Johnny, would you mind very much if I got into this?
Please feel free.
Okay, I'm feeling free now. Oh, it's nice. Mark said... This is what Mark said. It doesn't say Mark who, it doesn't say, it just says Mark. Mark said, gosh, the Sydney Unemployment Office is unique. People go there in their blanks. Mark said, gosh, the Sydney Unemployment Office is unique. People go there in their blanks. Boing, ba-doing, boing. Boing, ba-doing, boing. Boing, ba-doing, boing. Boing, ba-doing. Really, Joy?
Okay, I've been there.
Oh, fascinating. Lawrence, Mark said, gosh, the Sydney Unemployment Office is unique. People go there in their blanks.
I'd say Jaguars.
In their Jaguars is... It's a funny one. In their Jaguars. Marty hasn't got that.
No,
I can tell.
I
bet a million dollars.
I certainly haven't got a Jaguar, that's for sure. I got
droves. In their droves. Mm. People go there in their droves. What model drove? Nolene hasn't got Jaguars.
I haven't got droves or Jaguars. No, they went there in their birthday suits. That's pretty unique.
They went there with nothing on.
Well, I thought, you see, it would be unique if they were very posh and went there in their dinner suits.
In their dinner suits. Everyone's taking a different route here. What's Joy got?
An entirely different one. Their underwear.
In their jockets. Philip.
I was playing along with Joy on this one.
Well, I'm going to tell Reg.
I am going to. I came up with briefs. Yes.
They're briefs. Yes. Peter.
I was playing along with Joy too.
Underwear.
Oh, well, oh. The bottom line has it.
See, they didn't think the way you were thinking. Naughty panel. Before Ugg the caveman invented the first musical instrument, he used to play tunes on his blank. Yes, he did. Before Ugg the caveman invented the first musical instrument, he used to play tunes on his blank.
You're looking over my shoulder.
I'm allowed to. I'm the star.
All right.
Have you finished, Nolan?
Yeah.
Must have been very little, one. Whatever. Yes. Nolan wrote a short one. When you hear those little bells go off, it means people are electronically locking in their answers. Everyone is locked in, so I'm allowed to ask the question. Before Ugg the caveman invented the first musical instrument, he used to play tunes on his blank.
Chest.
On his chest. How could you do that? Boing, doing, doing, doing. Boing, doing. I suppose you could if you had all your hairs tuned in the key of C and an E string and an F.
Yes, yes.
Marty?
Unfortunately, he used to play tunes on his club.
Used to play tunes on his club.
The
Malabar RSL. Nolene, can you imagine this caveman? He's got nothing. Like, there he is. The basic Homo erectus.
I'm glad to hear it.
Even in those days.
God, I hope I'm right.
Don't say even in those days.
Well, I can't say that. What's Neanderthal? I can't say it.
Something. Neanderthal.
Neanderthal. Mm. There he is, Nolene, with not a stitch on, and he wants to play a song to his beloved one. What is he going to do it on?
Well, obviously he plays on his chest because he's got bones there, and the ribs each make a different noise. His ribs.
His
is that
ribs is a
to
chest,
Tony?
I think. I think ribs are a chest. Tony's measuring himself now.
Yes.
He's a 48 regular.
He can't feel his ribs, that's
no,
why.
No, I'm sorry.
This guy could.
A chest is not a rib, you see. No, I'm sorry about that.
I tried.
Do you know what Adam said the first time he saw Eve?
What did he say?
He said, I've heard of spare ribs, but that's ridiculous.
And did she laugh?
No, either. Well, I thought being a caveman, he'd play on his stalactites and stalagmites.
Stalactites and stalagmites, those things that drip down in the night.
And grow up from the bottom.
That's right. I think I've been through that. Joy, you didn't know this was going to be that kind of game, did you?
Where people
played tunes on their stalactites which dripped in the middle of the night.
Yes. Well, I knew Ugg, you see. And Ugg played on his teeth.
On his teeth. Yeah. Pink, 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 pink. Oh, yes. Wouldn't that hurt after a while? Now, Philip's got something smart. And it's not his suit.
No smarter than Marty, who also suggested
play it on your club. Play it on your club. Peter, the same club. On your club. Well, we didn't get very far, did we, in round one? In fact, you could almost say total failure. So we'll be back to continue this devastating game shortly. Yes! Ha ha ha! Lawrence, this is round two, A or B?
A, thank you.
A, everybody plays because nobody matched anywhere along the way. When Frank found out his wife was coming to his office, he quickly hid his new secretary in the filing cabinet. He filed her under V for blank.
V?
V. As in victory.
Yes.
Oh, I shouldn't have said that.
Down.
Oh, well, you can't.
No.
No, you can't.
No.
When Frank found out his wife was coming to his office, he quickly hid his new secretary in the filing cabinet. He filed her under V for blank. This group of celebrities that we're working with have come up with some very original answers which are not going to help Lawrence all that much, I don't think. There's a variety up there. When Frank found out his wife was coming to the office, he quickly hid his new secretary in the filing cabinet. He did. He filed her under V for...
Vixen.
Vixen. Vixen, you little vixen. That's a good answer. Vixen. Marty, V for...
Vanessa the Undresser.
Vanessa. See, that's good. Vanessa was her name, perhaps.
Vanessa could have been a name, but I think the wife would have looked for V for Vixen, because that's, or H for Huzzy. But I put her under Virtuoso.
Oh, because she was so good at everything.
Typing and all that.
Oh, mm-hmm. Virtuoso. Johnny,
well, you see,
face.
I happen to have inside knowledge that her name was Virginia, so he put under V for Virgin.
Of course, that's yeah. That was my first thought. V for Virgin.
Oh, no. She'd been vanquished a few times.
V for vanquished.
I think that's Virgin on the ridiculous.
Oh. How would you like a punch in the face?
I put Virgin also.
Phillips put Virgin because, well, you know Phillips. You'll have to do 42 for that.
What, 42 episodes of Casino 10 or 42 Hail Marys?
Oh, you mustn't. That's immortal.
really boring.
No, it's not
very
boring. Nothing's very
that's
boring.
Terrible. That's
V for very pretty. Oh. No, see, Peter Tapano thinks like that, and that's a lovely answer. Never do it again. I can't say A or B to you because you're our champion, you see, and you don't get a choice. Joy said to Reg... Joy said to Reg, no wonder you're so hunched over. You've hooked your braces to your blank. Oh, dear. Joy said to Reg, no wonder you're so hunched over. You've hooked your braces to your blank. Boing, da-ding, boing. Boing, da-ding. Monotonous music we have. Very good monotonous music. Hunched over. Boing, ba-ding, boing. Come on, Peter. Come on, Joy Poo.
Having difficulty.
Come on, Marty. Oh, Peter's having trouble. What's she got here?
Oh, it's boring.
It's all right. It's all right. There are no correct answers. In blankety blanks, only matching ones. Joy said to Reg, no wonder you're so hunched over. You've hooked your braces to your...
Shoelaces.
She came up with it just like that. And you need one to win. You only need one to win. Does anyone have shoelaces here? Will one of the panel match? We'll find out tomorrow night. No, we won't. Shoelaces.
No, I'm not a poet, I'm afraid. I came up with toes.
Well, that would punch him over. Of course it would.
I had a picture of him sort of hunched over and ready to go. He'd hooked him to his launch.
Oh, to his cruiser.
Right.
Oh. Catapulted into Botany Bay.
Well, quaint old-fashioned thing that he is,
yeah.
The Reg that I'm thinking of, he wears suspenders and his socks.
Oh, so that's why he was hunched over. Joy knows more about this than anybody.
No, it couldn't have been us. It's someone else.
Kneecaps. Kneecaps. Philip. Hooked to his nose. And Peter hasn't got shoelaces either.
Doorknob.
Do you know what this doorknob, Peter? We have a tired game. on our hands because nobody has matched anywhere, anywhere at all, at ever. Would you like me to do the tide game now? No. All right, we'll do the tide game part after we come to the thing. You know, we're going to the... We have a tiebreaker on our hands, and we're going to break some ties now. Tiebreaker is played like anything else. Lawrence, A or B?
I'll stay with A, thanks.
A. In a tiebreaker, everybody plays. Christine said, "My husband is so mean. On our iron wedding anniversary, all he gave me was a blank." Christine said, "My husband is so mean. On our iron, I-R-O-N, wedding anniversary, all he gave me was a blank." Come on, Peter. That's a good idea.
You like it?
Silly Philip can't think of anything. But he has. Yes. Oh. Christine said, "My husband is so mean. On our iron wedding anniversary, all he gave me was a blank."
So just an iron.
Just an iron. All he gave me was an iron. Like as in ironing. You may well be right. Marty.
Look, it's obvious.
See, you were right. Nolene, my love.
I think we're going to have to call on Tony about this because I've got a pressing. Now, that's an iron.
A pressing.
Yes.
Gave him a pressing.
It is. Pressing.
Mm. This could take a while.
Can only be done with an iron.
I haven't always done this for a living.
It's a bit ambivalent.
Oh, it's a bit ambivalent.
All What's right.
Happening? Not a match?
No.
King
and I'm never talking to you again.
I thought he was meaner than that. He gave her a wash shirt to iron.
Oh, that's good. And Johnny's in the shirt business. Joy, what do we have?
The only thing that I could think that was made out of iron that he could give it would be a gate.
A nice gate. Here you are, darling. This is for our iron. Yes, that's funny. That's funny. Open this, he said.
Because it's... because it was their iron anniversary, he gave her some starch.
Yes. Oh, Philip is not as dull as he appears in Casino. What have you got, Peter?
An ironing board
is a nice idea. Well, it wasn't fruitless altogether. You've got one there. So that means, Catherine, you'll need two to win. The explorer brought the first garbage can to the North Pole, and right away, two Eskimos started blanking it. I don't write the questions. The explorer brought the first garbage can. Little exercise for camera three. The explorer brought the first garbage can to the North Pole, and right away, two Eskimos started blanking in it.
Blanking it?
Oh, I beg your pardon. Oh, I've committed the most terrible sin. Don't write. The explorer brought the first garbage can to the North Pole, and right away, two Eskimos started blanking in it.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
If
you're locked in, we'll unlock you. Could we have everyone unlocked, please? My fault. Blanking in it, not blanking it. I rarely do that. How unusual for a great star. My fault that there was a hold up there because I gave the question incorrectly. The explorer brought the first garbage can to the North Pole, and right away, two Eskimos started blanking in it.
Skiing?
Skiing in it. The little tiny Eskimos skiing. Skiing? Skiing?
Well, look, I was so quick with the first one, and it took me so long to write it that I couldn't be bothered changing, so I left it as rubbishing.
Started rubbishing in it. That's all right. Yeah. Narlene?
No, they thought it was a bit better than those little ice block houses they lived in, so they lived in it.
Started living in it, yes. I'd rather live in a garbage can than an igloo.
Anytime.
Do you know that the makers of Tide washing powder did a promotion round there? They went up to an igloo and said to the lady, do you wash in Tide? She said, yes. He said, why? She said, it's too bloody cold, out Tide.
In Tide and out Tide.
I like that one.
I like it too.
I thought they were blubbering in it.
Blubbering, yes, yes. That's what Eskimos eat, of course. They eat a whale and blubber. Wouldn't you have had to eat whale? Joy, my love, no, my heart, my darling heart, treasure face.
Oh, goodness. These little persons were fishing in it.
Having a little fish and got a kick in the ice hole.
Well, I don't know about that.
Because it was garbage, I thought they were scavenging in it.
Scavenging
in it. Yeah, scavenging in it.
Scavenging in it.
Scavenging
hard
in
to
it.
Say. Uh-oh. Because Catherine needs one... anyone to stay in the game,
hey,
Peter.
Me.
Yes. What have you got?
Well, I thought seeing it was very cold, they might be snuggling in it.
Snuggling in it. So, Lawrence Sutton is our new champion. Come up, Lawrence. And Catherine Twyford goes home with $100. Better than nothing. Bye-bye, and thank you for playing Blankety Blanks. Good night. Good night. Oh, not good night to you. Goodbye to... Well, she's going slowly. She doesn't want to go. We'll be back in a minute too, right after we do some business. And good night to you. We thought we might play, you know, I polled a recent studio audience. We're not going to play then. We've got to do that tomorrow night. You can come back tomorrow night with a different tie on. Different set. See you then. Bye-bye. And it's my my privilege to thank you all for playing Blankety Blanks and hope that we see you again shortly. Mm. Marty and Nolan and Johnny and Peter and Joy and Philip.
I can't remember, Graham, when I last enjoyed myself so much.
Oh, yeah, I bet you can't either. Good night, everyone, from Blankety Blank. Oh,
all prices are moved by Grace Brothers Removals, the professionals. Interstate artists Fire Set and Drive Avis, we try harder. Whilst in Sydney, Graham Kennedy chooses to stay at the Boulevard Hotel, 90 William Street, King's Cross. is a Reg Grundy production, produced in colour at the studios of Channel 10 Sydney in association with the O10 Network. John Blake speaking.